spiritual. What we discussed yesterday? We already discussed about the meaning of biology. Bio means life, logic means study. The complete meaning will be study of life. Right? So, continuation of the previous class, today we will discuss with the topic again. And its components. What we are discussing? Continuation of the yesterday's topic. Today we will discuss about again cell and components of the cell. First, if you brush up with the previous class, just remember about our previous class. We already discussed that. If you see history of a cell, there was a scientist called Robert Hooke. In which year? 1665. Right, Anna? In which year we discussed? In 1665, Robert Hooke examined a bark of tree. What he examined? A bark of tree under which a magnifying lenses which he prepared by his own self. What he did? In 1665, Robert Hooke examined the bark of the tree under his magnifying lenses which he prepared by his own. And what he observed? He observed honeycomb-like structures which are in hexagonal shape. Which are in hexagonal shape. Right or wrong? Let's try to discuss. So, and he called it as cell. Right? What he called as honeycomb-like structures? Cell. And the Latin word of cell is called smallus. What is the Latin word? Smallus. Again, I'm repeating. Robert Hooke in 1665, he observed the bark cells and he identified that there is a comb-like structures and he called it as cell. Yesterday we already discussed about many experiments, like we take onion peel, we tried it with matchstick cells, and we also tried it human cheek cells in our cells also. What we find there? There is a complication of structure. Right or wrong? They have a complication with matchstick and they have a complication with onion and the cheek cells. Why we discuss that there is a variation? They have variation due to their dead living cells. We take dead cells in case of matchstick, whereas in case of onion and the cheek cells, they are live cells. And onion will be a plant cell and that cheek cell is an animal cell. What? Onion is a plant and cheek cells are animal cells. If you observe these two under the microscope, if you see the cell, a cell is surrounded with a special membrane. What is surrounded? A cell is surrounded with a special membrane and that membrane we call as cell membrane. What is that? That membrane we call as cell membrane. We also have studied in the previous classes that every cell has its own membrane and we call it as cell membrane. And plant and animal both have cell membranes. If we observe plants in the microscope, this will be a special feature of plants. What it will be? There will be a special feature of plant cell. That means it was surrounded by another layer called cell wall. It is surrounded by another layer called cell wall. That is the different feature which we observe lab animals. What we are discussing? First, in the cell, Robert is the first robot to discover cell in 1665 under his magnifying lens. With the bark of a bee, he observes honeycomb like structures and he called it as the cell. Cell means Latin verb, living rooms or small rooms. So here we are taking morning and the cheeses, whereas the matchstick is a dead cell. In the previous class, we did experiment with matchstick and this onion cells and also cheeses. In that, matchstick is a dead cell, whereas onion cell is a plant cell and cheeks are animal cell. What we are discussing? If this is a cell, what we are saying, if this is a cell, the cell has its a membrane, more membrane called cell membrane, and it have a plant cell, particularly a plant cell have a special feature called cell wall, which is surrounded by a cell and the cell membrane. Clear? What we are saying? Onion is a plant cell, cheek cell is the animal cell. Cheek cell and the plant cell or onion cell have cell membrane, a common part. But plants have a special feature called cell wall, which is surrounded by a cell, which helps in the protection of plant cells. Clear? Up next. Methyl and blue. Methyl and blue is a chemical which helps in the giving color to the particular substance. It packs some color to the substance where it is added. If we add this to an onion piece, what will it happen to this? Again, add this and cover with cover slip. Cover with cover slip. Here, we have a special addition step that pour some water through the cover slip. What we have to do, this is a slide. I'm placing a cover slip by placing an onion in and placing cover slip. From one side of the cover slip, just pour a drops of water. Then the onion peel will soak with the methyl and blue. What will happen? Onion peel will soak with the methyl and blue. After soaking, just take a tissue and apply it there. It absorbs all the remaining water. Then you observe this under the microscope. If we didn't keep a tissue there, if the water doesn't absorb by the particular tissue, there will be a formation of bubbles. There is a possibility of formation of bubbles. That's why we have to keep a tissue there and we have to take water out. If you observe under the microscope, yesterday what we said? If this is a cell, there will be structures like this. Right or wrong? There will be a structures like this. When we did this experiment, this methyl blue will impact in the nucleus of the particular cell and your nucleus will shown in color of blue. Which color? Blue. It contains the tint or it gets blue color and it shows blue color. That is the identification of presence of nucleus. Clear? What we did? Onion piece, cutting the pieces, place this onion piece on the side, right? And covered or added or flooded with the methylene. Methylene is a chemical which impacts blue color to a particular thing. So after this, cover with the cover slip, pour some water from the some side of the cover slip, then extract this water with tissue. If we observe under the microscope, what we will see? There will be a blue color in the cell. The blue part is called nucleus. And they have other parts. This will be a these are the cells, this will be a cell wall, basal, and there is a jelly substance which is called as cytoplasm. What it is called? Cytoplasm, which helps in the floating of all the components of the cell. Cell has many components like ribosomes, mitochondria, cell wall, nucleus, ribosomes, mitochondria, nucleus, plastids, etc. And these all will float on the semi-solid substance called cytoplasm. What it called? Cytoplasm. In the later on classes, we all will discuss about all these terms. For your identification, I am saying it here. Again, I am saying onion happens like by flooded with the methyl and blue, by covered with the cover slip. If the particular cell have a nucleus, it gets or it attains blue color and it indicates in the blue color, that means the identification for the presence of nucleus. Clear? If we see same process in the animals, what we will do? If we see the same process in the onion cell, that means sheep cells. Sheep cells, if we see same process, take a sheep cell and place on slide. Again, it flooded with methyl and blue. What we got? Methyl and blue and covered with cover slip. Cell placed on the slide, flooded with the methyl and blue, covered with the cover slip. Same process. Pour some water and extract that water with the tissue. Again, we get a cell and get jelly substance, that is cytoplasm. Here, somewhere, we find a nucleus which is a blue color. This indicates the presence of nucleus in particular animal cell, whereas that experiment will help in the identification of nucleus in particular plants. Okay, this is about our class that Robert Brown in 17th century. Robert Brown invented a special structure of a cell. Sorry, the structure is contained in the cell called nucleus. Clear? This is about our class. In the next class, we will discuss the next.